Alright guys, 4S test flight with the Diatone GTR569. So this quadcopter is obviously meant to be flown on 6S. I'm gonna have a try to see what it performs like on 4S. I can expect that a lot of people have 4S specs and an array of 4S. So if you'd buy this quadcopter or any other 6S quadcopter, can you still have use for your 4S specs? Let's see if that's the case, at least with this Diatone.
Engines are...
It takes off. Okay, I have to say that I just flew it on a 6S, so we'll take a little bit of getting used to. But okay, yeah, so the punch out isn't as rocket like as on the 6S, right? Yeah, but it flies. I will do the same thing in FV, by the way, fly it on 6S and on 4S. We'll do that in a separate video, of course. But okay, from the looks of it, it takes a little getting used to, but it doesn't fly a whole lot different than a 4S quadcopter, if you know what I mean. So this quadcopter is actually available as a 4S version, but from the looks of it, there is no reason not to go for the 6S version. Why? Well, the 6S version you can fly on 4S and on 6S. Maybe you want to get into it, fly on 4S at the start of a session, get your finger movements going. And again, just like on 6S, I'm a bit surprised by how quiet the quadcopter is. I know these propellers, I've flown these flash propellers quite a lot on other quadcopters. And I know them to be a bit noisy, fast but noisy. On this quadcopter, I'm not sure why actually. I guess the tune works out well. Oh, by the way, I haven't retuned it for 4S. A minute ago I flew it on 6S and it was fine. On 4S it also, that's a bit surprising. Nice. Okay, so yeah, that's a nice test, I guess. It's definitely usable on 4S, this quad. So again, if you were considering to get this quadcopter, I would strongly suggest getting the 6S version. There is no reason not to. There is also not really a reason to fly it on 6S, by the way. Even if you are a beginner,
3 minutes.
It's not like 6S is more difficult or more dangerous. Basically, the only thing that's different, or that should be different, is that the voltage is higher and the amperage is lower, right? The performance should be more or less the same. In an ideal world, in which we don't live, but okay. It's not more intimidating to fly it on 6S, at least not this one. Yeah, fun to fly on 6S, nothing wrong with it. So, oh, by the way, this is a powerful 4S. Maybe that makes a difference somewhat. Maybe I'm cheating a little, but it's not like this is a 5S. That's basically also an option, of course. If you have 5S specs, you can fly this quad on 4S, on 5S and on 6S. Very versatile. And yeah, that goes for most any 6S quadcopter. Not all, but So that's, I can't believe how docile and controllable this quad is. Very easy to fly. It doesn't have LEDs, and part of the reason why I chose to fly it on these propellers is orientation, right? Black propellers at the rear, transparent at the front, but reasonably easy to keep track of because it flies so predictably. I was generally a bit worried, but there I shouldn't have been. Nice! Yeah, the punches are a bit lackluster when you've just flown a 6S. But it flies just fine. Cool! Successful test! Alright, well, my next video on this quadcopter will of course be an FPV test flight. And we'll do that on 6S and on 4S as well. Why not? For now, I want to thank you for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.
Engines disarmed.
Ah, damn! Even this, just the landing, super controllable. What's going on with this quad? This, I sit it down, and most quadcopters all have a little bit of a bounce. Oh, okay, this time I did have a bounce. Hot damn!
Telemetry lost.